Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So yesterday we have started our new lesson and the name of the lesson is what? Changes around us. In that yesterday we have discussed about the two types of the changes, that are natural changes and human made changes. Okay, so what is meant by natural changes? The changes that occurs naturally and which cannot get controlled by human being, that changes are called as natural changes. While the changes which occur due to the human efforts, okay, or due to the some human activities, and that changes are called as what? Human made changes. Okay, so if we talk about the changes, so there are the so many, or there is the list of the changes is never ending. There are the so many different changes occurs in our surrounding, that are natural changes or human made changes. Okay, so there are the so many changes are present or the which occurs in our surrounding. Okay, so it can be grouped. Yes, these all the changes can be broadly grouped into two types, or there are the two main types of the changes, that are reversible change and irreversible change. Okay, what? Reversible change and irreversible change. So among these two changes, today we'll discuss deeply about the reversible change. Okay, so let's see what is meant by reversible change. Okay, from the name only you will understand that re means what? Again. Reversible, which will get again, that change is called as what? Reversible change. Okay, so let's discuss the definition of the reversible change. The change that can be reversed easily by reversing the conditions to obtain a substance in its original form is called reversible change. Okay, so what happened exactly in the reversible change? It is the one type of the change that can be reversed easily, which comes back easily. Okay, the original product, the original material, we are getting back again in their original form. Okay, how? By reversing the conditions to obtain a substance in its original form. Okay, so in a simple words we can say that the reversible change are the changes in that the original substance or the original material we are getting back as it is. Okay, but how we will get that things back? By reversing certain types of the conditions, by reversing the conditions. Okay, so we are changing certain conditions to get the original material or original product as it is, and that changes is called as what? Reversible change. Okay, again I will repeat, the change that can be reversed, which comes back easily by reversing the condition, with the help of the reversing the condition, we'll get the original form of the substance as it is, and that change is called as what? Reversible change. Okay, so there are the so many different examples of the reversible change. Among that we will discuss one example with the help of one activity. Okay, so let's start the activity. Okay, so let's start the activity. So with the help of this activity, what we will discuss? That to study the effect of hanging weight on a spring. Okay, so whenever we'll hang some weight on this spring, we'll observe that which type of the changes is happens in the spring, and also whenever we'll remove the weight from this spring, then which type of the changes happens in the spring. Okay, so let's discuss. Okay, or let's see or observe the properly. So see here, I have hang one spring. For that spring, now I will hang one weight. Okay, before that you have to observe this spring properly. See the length of the spring properly. Okay, can you see the length of the spring? Yes, now it is this much length of the spring. Okay, now I will insert one weight in this spring and I will leave this weight slowly. Okay, so what you have observed? That the length of the spring is get changed. Okay, before hanging the weight, the length of the spring was short, but when I add this weight into the spring, the length of the spring is get increase. Okay, or it get increase in the size or increase in the length. Okay, now again I will remove this. Okay, so this height or the length of the spring is get increased by hanging the weight in it. Now I'll remove this weight and let's see what happens. Okay, what happened? Again it comes to its original shape. Okay, or again it comes to its original size. Okay, so whenever I will add these weight in the spring, it get increase in a size, and whenever I remove this weight, then it comes to its original size. Okay, means what? The original spring we are getting as it is. So this is the one example of the reversible change. Same thing is happens in the reversible changes, that what the original product or the original material, original substance we are getting as it is. Okay, so see here we are getting the same size of the spring. Okay, and again whenever we are adding this weight in it, it change its size, but whenever we are removing this weight, it comes to its original size. Okay, the what? It is the reversible change, means the original substance we are getting back by changing the some conditions. Okay, now let's see the next example. Okay, now let's see the next example of the reversible change. Okay, so see, as we know, there are the three states of a water, that is solid, liquid and gas. Okay, or we can say that there are the three states of all matters, okay, which are what? Solid, liquid and gas. And if we'll talk about the water, then the ice is the solid state of water. Water that we are drinking, that is the liquid state of water, and the steam or the water vapor, this is the gaseous state of the water. Okay, so all these are states are interchangeable, that we have discussed in our previous classes. Okay, so all these three states of the water are interchangeable. Okay, and that interchangeable states of the water is nothing but the one example of what? Reversible change. Okay, so let's see. So whenever we are giving the heat to the ice, then what happens? It gets started to melt and it gets converted into the water. Okay, so whenever we are providing, or whenever the ice is removing from the freezer, then with the help of this room temperature, it started to melt. And this ice means what? The solid state. And it started to melt and get converted into what? Liquid state. Okay, so ice, whenever it getting the heat, it gets converts into the water. But whenever again if we'll provide the cool, or again whenever we will cool the water, then this water again will get changed into the ice. Okay, so it means what? The melting of ice is nothing but which type of the change? Reversible change. Okay, so what happens? Whenever ice is getting heat, it gets converts into the water. But when will we cool the water, then this water again get converts into the ice. Okay, so it means what? The melting of ice is nothing but what? Reversible change, because we are getting the original product, original substance again, that is nothing but what? Ice, by changing certain condition, by giving or by providing the cooling to the water, we can get the ice back. Okay, next one is there, we can say that whenever we boil the water, or boiling of the water, what produce? It produce the water vapor, that is called as what? Steam. Okay, so that water is means what? Liquid state. Okay, so whenever we are providing, or when we heat the water, then that water started to boil and it get convert into the steam, that is nothing but what? Which state of the water? Gaseous state. Okay, so the water, when get heat, it started to get boil and get converts into the steam. Okay, next one is that, and whenever we are cooling this steam, then that steam is again get converts into the water. Okay, so it means what? The boiling of the water is nothing but which type of the change? Reversible change, or the conversion of the water into the gaseous state is nothing but the reversible change. Why reversible change? Because when we are giving heat to the water, it get converted into the steam, but by giving the cooling, or by providing the cooling to the steam, we can get that water back. And that is the reason the boiling of the water is the reversible change. Okay, so up till now we have discussed about the three examples of the reversible change. First one we have discussed about the stretching of the spring is a reversible change, melting of ice is a reversible change, boiling of water is also the reversible change. Okay, so now we will discuss for the next example, that is, see, can you see this? This is what? Rubber band. Okay, so see this original shape of the rubber band. Okay, so this is the shape of the rubber band. Now I will stretch it. Okay, so I have stretched the rubber. So can you see it get increase in a size, but whenever I release the pressure on it, it comes to its normal shape. Okay, it's come back to its original shape. Okay, so in this means what? Stretching of the rubber is also one example of what? Reversible change. Why? Because it comes to its normal shape again. Okay, we are applying the pressure, or we are applying certain force on it. By that force, it get increase in the size, it gets stretch. And whenever we release the force from it, it comes to its normal position. Okay, so that is what the stretching of the rubber is, what? Reversible change. Okay, now we'll discuss about the one more example, that is glowing of the electric bulb. So let's discuss one more example of the reversible change, that is glowing of bulb. Okay, so you can see the glowing of the bulb. Whenever I on the button, the bulb started to glow, but whenever I will off the button, then what happened? The same bulb is present here. So there is no any change in the bulb happens, still we have providing the electricity to it. Okay, it means what? The glowing of the bulb is also what? Reversible change. There is no any change in the bulb, the original bulb we are getting as it is. Okay, so in this way, what we can say, that glowing of the bulb is also one reversible change. Whenever we'll off the electricity, it will get into its original form. So it is also the one more example of the reversible change. So today we have discussed about the reversible change. Also we have discussed about the different examples of the reversible change, that we have discussed about the stretching of spring. Also we have discussed about the melting of ice, boiling of water, stretching of rubber, and also we have discussed about the glowing of the bulb. And all these are nothing but the reversible change, in that we are getting the original product back as it is. Okay, so this is all about today. We'll discuss the next point in the next video. For today, thank you.